This weekend we have Nate Diaz and Jorge Masvidal, UFC 244, Madison Square Gardens. And we have Sensei Kutz here. We're here at Ludwig Martial Arts. Let's talk about this fight a little bit. A couple things that I feel, or we feel, we were just talking about for Masvidal to be effective. One thing is footwork to keep Nate Diaz off of him, right?
Yes, yes.
So he has good footwork. So using that footwork to, again, pull him in, make Nate miss, make him pay with more power shots.
Yes.
He's been really good at keeping good position, good boxing, good head motion as well. So in the pocket, he can exchange if he needs to. Pull crossing, better wrestling. If he gets in trouble in the strikes at all and does allow Nate to pressure him, he could take a ground fillet, has better wrestling, looks to be stronger as well. What are your thoughts on that as far as...
I think he has the grappling to defend against Diaz for the most part and also use his own grappling if he needs to.
Yes.
Wrestle him to the ground, stay safe on the ground. Avoid the danger of the submissions.
He did survive Damian Maia three rounds.
He did. Diaz is always dangerous, but if you can survive Maia, you could probably survive most people.
Agreed.
I think he can avoid the takedown altogether with, like you said, good footwork, good head movement, making Nate miss, and then quick to get his back off the fence, circling away from the fence.
Nice.
Similar to how he did with Till. They had some exchanges where Masvidal used his head movement and right away circled away from the fence and stop the pressure. Diaz is going to have to rely on his pressure. Mm. So if Masvidal can take that away, he could definitely be successful on the feet as well.
Agreed. Very nice. Let's break down a few of those things in here for things for Masvidal to be successful. Open stance means that you're in opposite stances. And the body kick right there is open for both guys. And one thing that Masvidal did quite a bit against Till was work the body kicks. Boom. Now, I feel he should do that to Nate Diaz. Get some body kicks in the mix. Body shots, set up head shots. So one thing that Nate Diaz has to be mindful of is not to get caught like he did against Josh Thompson, where he dips to the rear hip, avoiding the body kick, but dipping into the head kick range, boom. That's exactly how Josh Thompson was able to catch Nate Diaz in their fight. Body shots, setting up the cross kick upstairs. Here's a little trick and tip on that actual technique. Again, so body shot, boom. And he's gonna be wanting to step away, keeping his distance, boom, body shot. And whether they're body shots or not, or just head punches, getting the head in motion and selling that punch as if you're gonna throw that, have the kick come right behind that, that is going to be the offbeat rhythm attack that he can do against Nate Diaz, because Nate Diaz does slip to his rear hip quite a bit, which most people do, but hitting those body shots like he did against Till, boom, get some more body shots, Masvidal getting those body shots in, and then getting Nate to dip into the high kick is one thing that Masvidal can look for in the fight and that Nate Diaz needs to be mindful of to avoid. So Nate should, which he typically does, is works the double jab cross quite a bit, and Masvidal is probably gonna back up and make him miss. Boom, that is make him pay. Sensei, you wanna take a two from here? Boom, what's up with any of that?
So Diaz, with his long punches, will be successful if Masvidal doesn't move his feet. Masvidal's got good footwork and head movement, can get Diaz extended and then make him pay for that long punching style. Just like he showed with Darren Till, he's got the ability to punch and seamlessly switch his feet while he's punching, similar to how TJ Dillashaw does. He could be very effective in that scenario.
Sure. Let's talk about the intangible rhythm and the feel and the energy, the sixth sense. One thing that Conor McGregor does quite a bit from the open stance scenario is he takes the inside lane and he baits people to throw their power shot, and then they pull across him. Same thing that Masvidal can do against Nate Diaz, because Nate looks to pull and close the distance, so when he does that, he's gonna pull across him. And it's something that's done not by thought, but by feel, and since it's a pretty common open stance scenario, that's one thing that I feel Masvidal is going to be able to do quite a bit to Nate Diaz. If he gets him reaching the catcall and a pawn too much, he's gonna pull cross him. And to get better at that as an actual drill, some things that you guys can do that I suggest that I have my fighters do, or my students in general, is we know the drill. Your foot's inside, you shouldn't be in there because you're baiting the cross, right? You don't wanna go into their power, but you know the power's there. So make him throw it, and then you can pull cross him, setting him up. Same scenario as if you're in someone's guard and you reach for the throat. You're not supposed to do that because they're gonna do arm what? Says they're gonna armbar you. But I already know. So if I reach for the throat, I'm in the guard, they open up the legs, hip in, arms back, pass. Same scenario. He shouldn't be inside my power zone because I'm gonna throw my power, right? Well, go ahead, pull cross him. That's one thing that Masvidal is gonna be able to do to Nate Diaz quite a bit this weekend. So he has to be mindful of that. But again, to make that an actual drill, One thing that the partners can do is go double jab, and I'm gonna go double jab cross to close the distance, because here's the distance. I shouldn't be able to land my punches without bringing my feet. And that's right now I can't, so I gotta bring my feet. So we do these drills, make sure you do them from a distance where you can't touch the partner's mitt until you bring the feet. What I'm gonna do is go double jab on his rear mitt, and then I'm gonna miss my cross by him slipping it, boom, and he's gonna pull across me. So it's an offensive, defensive drill where I'm attacking with the double jab, throwing the cross over the shoulder, having him miss it, and then pull crossing me. So that is a drill that's already predetermined, and we know who's doing what. The goal of the drill is for me to land the double jab and miss the cross for him to pull cross me. And we know what the drill is, but act like you don't know. Shut the brain off, feel the flow, because the body knows things before the brain does, and that's a way to develop this drill, is actually just doing it with the actual brain on autopilot. Here is a technique and drill that both Nate Diaz and Jorge Masvidal could both be successful with, or really anybody in an open stance scenario. So what it is the double jab cross and then leaping into a lead head hook. But the double jab is aimed to the head to get them backing up a ton, which exposes the body. Now the body shots will set up the head shots. One thing I like to make sure you are doing is getting your lead foot outside their lead foot, so you have the angle on that scenario. So again, it's just double jab cross hook, dropping your weight on the body cross, and say you want to get a couple for me, double jab cross, boom, getting them to bend over and then hopping on the head hook. Depending on the distance, whether you hop or not, a lot of people say not to hop or jump in the fights, but it happens all the time, so I suggest go ahead and practicing that and becoming aware and comfortable with it. One person that hopped quite a bit was Mike Tyson. No one told him not to hop. I think people actually told him to hop. Customato and Mickey Rooney, so they are definitely great trainers, obviously, and if they are having their fighters do it, I think other people should have their fighters do that. So again, double jab cross, getting those headshots up in there, so he's leaning back, opening up the body, boom, hitting a good clean body shot, foot outside, a good angle, loading the weight on that lead hip and hopping off that for the head hook. And then he can go back to the body or whatever it may be. One common thing that would open up off that is since they take off quite a bit, let them take off, boom, and then that sets them up perfectly for the kick or the jump knee. We all know he has the fastest knockout for the jump knee now. I'm not bitter. So there are some tips and tricks on ways for Masvidal to be successful. Now let's talk about Nate Diaz. A way for Nate to be successful is work that double jab cross to close the distance here. Double jab cross, boom, and what he does is he falls into the clinch off that with their collar tie and their wrist control. From here, he's looking to get some knees to the body. Once you knee to the body, he's gonna wanna protect that. When he goes to protect that, that opens up the knees to the head. When you're in the clinch here, one thing that I used to do is I would listen to my opponent's breathing patterns. When they would be breathing in, poof, I would go to knee him. So when they're breathing out, you're trained, and you should be training to be able to receive a shot as you're breathing out. But when you're breathing in, that's the time to hit them. I got that trick from Sensei Boss Rutten. He did that against one of his early pancreas fights. When he needs the guy to deliver, he just looks like he got hit with a shotgun. But learn to listen to your opponent's breathing patterns and knee them when they're breathing in, if you can actually time that. So that's a good time, a little trick and tip in there, is again to listen to your opponent's breathing patterns and knee them, strike them while they're breathing in. Here, again, is a very specific exchange that Nate Diaz is probably going to be doing this weekend, working the double jab cross. Boom, he overextends his punches quite a bit, but he steps and he falls into the clinch, and he does great in this clinch zone, the dirty boxing. Again, with the wrist control, the collar tie here, throw knees to the body, body shots, sit up head shots, and so on. So that right there is definitely gonna be happening this weekend, as long as he doesn't get too extended and pull cross like Masvidal is gonna be looking to do. So here's another way that Nate Diaz will be successful against Masvidal is, again, applying pressure, but getting some body shots in there. Masvidal has great head motion, so if he still punches to the head, his head's in motion, harder to hit that, but the body's always there, so are the legs. So one thing that I feel Nate Diaz will be doing this weekend is throw some head shots, getting Masvidal to move his head, opening up the body, because you know he always hits the body a couple shots too, and then comes back up to the head. So look for that to happen. Some head shots, getting his head moving, working some body shots, coming back up to the head, head, body, head. They should both attack the body. I think they both will. One thing that Nate does is he throws front kicks, sorry, and he'll just throw out some front kicks there, and when they start, or they, or your opponent, or Masvidal starts defending those front kicks by bringing his guard in, that sets up the, I call it the Kyokushin kick, Kyokushin karate. What Kyokushin means is the ultimate truth, another topic. But Kyokushin fighters, they're working the body quite a bit because there's no face punches, and they were able to develop really flexible high kicks with power from close range. So with that being said, Same type of thing is hitting those front kicks, getting him to bring in his guard and faking that front kick to a high kick. They call it the question mark kick, basically. So you're faking a linear attack to a round attack. One thing that Nate Diaz are probably gonna be doing is, again, landing some front kicks and then selling that to the actual high kick. That's a little trick and tip to work on open stance, and it's open against both people. And which is what I was talking about too with Masvidal. Hitting some straight shots, sitting up that body, getting to dip outside for the high kick. Same scenario, because people tend quite a bit to dip to the rear hip. So whether it's the front kick to the round kick, or whether it's the fake cross to the round kick, or just double body kick to the high kick, boom, those are all good techniques to set up the actual knockout upstairs. So here's another open stance technique that works against both people. I was actually able to do this against Eves Edwards, who was a southpaw stance fighter, and I was orthodox in the fight. One thing that I did to him was I just touched the hook upstairs to open up the guard, because they're gonna wanna defend that head hook. So let them defend that, and as soon as they defend, you're throwing the cross to the belly. Because again, headshots set up body shots set up headshots, and now I'm just selling this hook to the head, boom, boom, and hitting that cross. But here's one thing that Nate Diaz does quite a bit on his two, his jab cross. He brings the cross right behind the jab, almost as if the jab is pulling the cross right behind it. He doesn't do a traditional jab cross. They are right behind each other, and that overwhelming pace gets into people's brains and the soul gets them tired. My point with that is, when hitting this hook upstairs, I don't want you to go hook and then cross. The cross has to be right behind the hook. As he's defending the hook, the cross is right behind it again, so the cross should be pulled by the hook itself. So that's another open stance trick and tip. When you're doing this, it's better to have your lead foot outside their lead foot, just so you're not setting up for the power. But here's another little trick and tip. Is in the open stance, people are always looking to throw their cross. You can actually give them a reason to throw the cross. I can go hook, cross to the belly, get Sensei throw his cross, and then me pull cross him. So if your foot's outside, which it should be for the most part, just keep this angle, you should be safe from that for the most part. If your foot's inside, look to still do the same thing, but pull cross. So don't hang out there too long and get countered with that. What I would do again is touch both, pull cross to set that one up. If your foot's outside, go ahead and set on that. Another thing you can do, as we talked about earlier, is hopping on the head hook. So a couple more open stance tricks and tips. I always get asked about some things to do from the scenario. There it is right there. Little open stance flow drill for you to play with, inspired by the great Nate Diaz. So that's it. So open stance, opposite stances. We're gonna close the gap, dump jab cross. Off that cross, I'm gonna step the half clinch collar tie here while I'm getting wrist control. Now we're back in the same, well not back, we're in the same stance now. We're closed stance here, being orthodox. What I wanna do is use my forearm here to push him back on his heels as I step behind him to load my left knee to the body, which will set up the knee to the head. From there, little pummel here, head position. You get another knee if you want. I like to keep the head position in here, let go, get the shoulder roll, three uppercuts, four uppercuts, however many you want, and then a head hook exiting outside. You can just exit outside if you want, or off the hook, come back through and get it fit in. Up to you, a couple flow options off of that. Let's look at that one more time. Again, start the drill in a distance where you can't touch the mitts unless you step. So it should be actually knuckles to knuckles, which is why he did that. So from that distance now, double jab on his rear mitt, boom, boom, cross. I'm stepping outside of him just out of good habit in general as far as staying away from the power, but that really loads me up for the stepping half clinch, collar tie, whatever you want to call it. As I'm getting that though, I'm getting wrist control as well. I'm gonna use my forearm and weight to put him back on his heels and step one more time for the body knee. Now, I'm feeling one body knee, you do two, three, to the point where he starts defending that, which will set up the head knee, okay? The knee to the head is the number one knockout in MMA from the clinch, so make sure you don't just rush that. Put some quality into it. I mean, don't smash your partner's face, but just touch a nice line. But if it's an actual pad or the bag, make sure you're drilling that, put some emphasis on the actual knee. From there, when he picks his head up, that's a perfect time to pummel underneath to get the actual pummel head positioned here. You can get some more knees if you want, and now here is the time to get the shoulder roll. One, two, three. Foot's outside, hopping on the head hook, exiting from there if you like, or again, off that hook, shaking back through for the finish for the double, which is the number one takedown in MMA. Same thing, I wanna get one ninja. So again, double jab cross, and we overthrow that cross. Double jab for me. Overthrow the cross, you can step right into the collar tie, half clinch, wrist control. But using that forearm to step, putting me on my heels, stepping out beside me for that body knee, head knee, boof. Right from there, they're gonna wanna stand up. Perfect time to get that pommel. Head position, some more knees. Shoulder roll, 3, 4, 5 uppercuts. Boom, and a head hook, boom. So, little clinch MMA flow drill inspired by the great Nate Diaz. Again, Masvidal forward to pull him in. Nate forward to apply pressure and apply his ground and pound dirty boxing game. Who do you think we got? I'm gonna have to go with, I can never bet against Nate Diaz, but I'm gonna have to go with Nate Diaz. A little bit closer to the West Coast. Did a couple of my classes in Sacramento before. Super nice, humble, respectful guy, hardworking. Masvidal, same thing, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna lean with Nate on this one.
I'm gonna lean to Masvidal.
Nice.
I think he's used to fighting the bigger size welterweights more. Yeah, he has the power. I think if Diaz wins, it has to be by grinding him out in a decision.
Mm-hmm.
I think Masvidal could possibly finish.
He could finish. I agree with that. Masvidal has a possibility to finish for sure. Yeah. Because it's a 5-round fight as well.
Yes,
Nate Diaz never gets tired. What else are we going to say? I'm sorry. I interrupted on that one.
Huge fan of both.
Yes, sir.
Be really great. Happy either way. And it's going to be really exciting either way.
So. Awesome fight. UFC fans, thanks for putting this on. Muchas gracias.